Conrado, what's going on? I was just washing the dishes and suddenly the lights went out!
Don't worry, Mending. The lights will be back in a bit. There's just a little problem with the fuse, but there's nothing a little bit of tinkering can fix. I'll be back in a bit. I'll just head out for the electricity shop.
Good evening, sir. Do you need anything in particular?
Well, I don't need an electrician. The electricity went off in my house, but I think it's just a brick light. I put the switch off.
That's the first thing one should do. I think you will need a rubberized tape and a pair of new fuses.
I am sure of that, but how do I go about fixing it?
Simple. The line should never get mixed up. When the covering is worn out and they cross each other, that's when the trouble starts.
It's like a boy and a girl then. If they really get mixed up, then there's bound to be some result.
I hope you're not fooling me.
If you do not believe me, you can come to my house. It's close by, in Makati. It is dark.
I believe you. Well then, first to see to it is that the main switch is off. Then look for the line that was burned. Sometimes rats gnaw the line, so if you touch it and it's live,
I will not forget that.
Clean the wires, then tape them individually. Make sure that they do not meet, that they do not touch.
No touch, no harm. Thanks for that.
I will not sell it to you. I don't know what you're trying to do, but I know that you're not buying the goods to use. You don't need all those bulbs.
I like changing them. You know, different ones.
Mr. Lopez, tell me the truth.
I also like collecting lengths of wires, sockets, and bulbs. You know, Thomas Alva Edison? Maybe I'm an inventor.
You're a liar.
Yes, a terrible liar am I not.
What are you really trying to do?
I wanted to see you again. I want to talk to you. I enjoy being with you. That's a simple truth. I would like to take you home, but I don't have a car. We can have a taxi if you want.
But I prefer Calesas. It's a fine afternoon. Can we walk?
Of course.
I've lived here all my life. I'm familiar with every alley there
is. I see. So you know those streets, like I know the street of Makati, Bambang, and Melbourne. The places are from the house.
We all complain
if we didn't
know where that is.
You're
not. Which Chinese or Indian? That's where they live anyway. Before the war, they said it was in the
I must tell you, Alex, I have some views on our Chinese problem.
Chinese schools should have been closed a long time.
But don't you like that?
Your plan is just for you.
What's your plan? Look at those people in town. They are neither Ilocanos or Malaysians.
Chinese girls never marry Filipino boys. It's always the other way around.
You call us Inchik Baboy.
Because it's true. You're Filipino. No, not you personally.
But Filipinos are stupid. Not you personally.
Look, it's our first time together and we're already quarrels.
You started it.
I don't like quarrels. Imagine if we get married.
Oh, you're going too fast. Now you're talking about getting married. We barely know each other.
After all those things I bought from your store, I could start another one.
Well, give them back to me and I will sell them for you.
I want to see you through your door. I'm not hiding. I am a bachelor. My intentions are I want to see your house. Maybe not tonight, but someday. Meet your parents.
I have no parents. I have three brothers and I am the youngest. My uncle, Mr. Dan, you have seen him in the store. He is our guardian. He took care of us when we were young.
I want to see where you live.
This is as far as you go, or you will not walk with me.
I'm sorry, I would like to see you.
It's 3 pesos and 25 centavos. It's in the receipt. In the receipt.
Coming round, city's people have found. You're the truest thing in this town, and I want you now. Shadows from the streetlight shades, watching every word you say. Never seen you lose.
So stupid of me for not having
seen you in seconds.
And I was worried about that. Filipinos are like that anyway. Go.
What's that?
Stupid, like you said.
Now, I hope you don't start an argument. What don't you like in a sentence?
First, you are lazy. You don't know what industry is.
You don't know what you're saying. We work very hard. Our farmers work very hard.
My father used to wake up at 4 o'clock in the morning, and we never sleep earlier than 11 o'clock at night.
Many Filipinos are like that.
And then you're so corrupt. Almost every week someone goes to the shop and all they ask is money. My uncle always gives, of course. And every time he increases the price of what he sells, on the other end, it is the customer who suffers.
It's just a state.
My father had to pay a bribe of 10,000 pesos way back in 1950 for his citizenship. It almost broke him.
So you're a Filipino citizen. This is where you make your living. Where rich Chinese people and your uncle make money exploiting the country. If you don't like it here, why don't you go back to Taipei or Taipei?
Be careful now. You misunderstood me completely. My brother, he was very impressed of what the communists were doing in Taipei. He went there and then returned. It was not that the life there is harsh, but he did not feel at home. Can you not see, Conrado? Our home is here. China, it would be foreign to me. I just want this country to have better things, less corruption and poverty.
It's just as well that we have our arguments now. Where will we get married?
Please, please don't talk about something impossible. Let us just be friends.
What time is it? I'm not making a lot, just 1,500. Plus that 400 pesos from the house. I can support you.
but not this time. My sister may not do well, but she may adjust. Let us meet her. There's just a two of us.
Cannot be, Conrado. I have been promised a marriage. Someone will marry. There's just a little time for it.
You must promise me that you will never go to the shop. Here, it's my attitude. You must promise me that you will only come visit tomorrow.
How will I see you?
I will see you here every Sunday.
Nothing more than that.
I've been thinking about her life. You would not need to spend much more if I got married. But of course, you would still live with us. Like it always has been. How does that sound to you, Apache?
I often wonder when it would be. I'm sure by now you know what type of girl is right for you.
Well, she's Chinese and I do not yet plan to have you three more.
Like other Chinese girls, it is also my dream to get married and start my own family. All my friends agree that Filipino men are better dates. They say Chinese dates talks about business. They have also said that Filipinos are better lovers.
And now you would like to know for yourself?
See, they never like having Chinese girls date Filipino boys. They think Filipino boys are making fools out of us.
Am I?
Somebody please set her free. Seeing her in pain is a miracle. I might owe you helping me, but helping her would save me. I don't want you to see the bloodshed of my body. And I draw you to the dark.
There's no whisper. Please remember.
We'll get married in the morning, if that's what concerns you. Now, if you want, we can walk to Malate Church and ask. I did not do this to take advantage of you, fool you.
I know.
Then what's the problem?
I cannot marry you.
You said because you're Chinese. But you love me. You said so. I'm not rich, but I won't let you starve.
It's not the money.
If it's not the money.
Traditions, customs, whatever you call it.
Hell with it.
My uncle, Conrado, he took care of us when we were orphaned. I told you. And there's this Chinese who lives in Green Hills. He is rich. He has helped my uncle, given my brother a very good job.
Alice, don't. Let us elope. Let's go to my house. They can find you there.
I am Chinese.
Where is Alice, Mr. Tan? Where can I find her then? Mr. Tan, I know you don't want a Filipino husband for your niece, but I love her and I want to marry her. If you think I'm interested in her money, I'm not. I have a good paying job and I can support her, so please.
Don't misunderstand, but you are very, very late. You must leave and don't bother us anymore.
But don't you like him?
Could have been one lonely night, just like the others, but you lit up my life. This is what it like to be lovers, you and me may never be lonely again. Spin with me endlessly, or at least until the end. Please never fall in love again. Oh, please never fall in love again. And if some other guy catches your eye, please just text me.
Thank God you're here.
Alex?
Conrado?